To make these gloves, I'm using a 4mm crochet hook and my yarn. So to start off, you want to make your slip knot. I'm going to start with a chainless foundation. So to do that, you want to chain two, and then yarn over, and insert your hook into the first loop, pull through, and then pull through one loop, and then yarn over and pull through all of them. And you want to repeat this until your chainless foundation is as long as you need it to go around the wrist that you're making for. So once you've done enough stitches, your beginning should look like this. And I've done a chainless foundation here because I find it a little bit stretchier. So once you've done that, you can join your two ends together. But it's a good idea to try it on for size just to be certain before you do that. So once you're satisfied that it will be the right size, you can join your ends together. So to find your last stitch, insert the hook and then wrap your yarn around the hook, making sure that you're wrapping the right piece of yarn. Pull it through the stitch that you just went into and the other stitch on the hook, and that should join your ends together. And I'll sort out the tail end at the end. So I'm going to do half treble crochet all the way around here. So you want to chain two, then yarn over into your first stitch, and then pull your yarn through all the stitches. And then the same again in the next one. Put your yarn over, insert your hook, pull your yarn through, and then through all the stitches. And do this all the way around. So once you get to the end of the row, you can slip stitch back into the beginning. And your band's starting to form now. So you want to repeat these rows with your half treble crochet until you get up to the part where you're going to add your thumb colour. This will vary depending on the size of the hand you're making for, so it's a good idea to measure as you go along. So once you get far enough to where you want to add your colour for your thumb, you can just join your two rows together. And then I'm going to use a stitch marker just to hold the stitch in place here because I don't want it to unravel. So it should look like this when you've done your first part. And you can check it to make sure it does fit. Like I say, as you go along, keep checking that it's fitting right. And then measure out how many stitches you need for your thumb. So you can insert your hook into the stitch and then at the stitch at the back, once you've counted out how many you need for your thumb. Put your hook through both of those just to mark your spot. And then take the contrasting colour that you want to use for your thumb part. And you want to pull that through both of those. So you've pulled it through both your stitches there at either side. And to hold it together while I'm crocheting, I'm just going to tie a knot. Now work through the first loop. And you can pull your contrasting colour up. So that's going to create the first loop of your thumb row. So next you want to chain two and work a half treble crochet. And then do the same for the next stitch and do it until you get round to the other side. Once you get to the beginning of your thumb row, you can slip stitch to join. That's completed the first row of your thumb part. And next you just want to do as many rows exactly the same as that to make the thumb part as long as you want it to be. This again will vary depending on the size of the glove you're making. So once you've completed as many rows as you want for your thumb part, you can slip stitch together for your last row. You can snip your wool and then pull it through to fasten off. So once your thumb part's complete, it should look something like this. So now you can return back to your main colour. Then remove your stitch marker. Then you want to do what you did before and chain two and then work half treble crochets all the way around. Only obviously you're not going to work in the thumb part because you've already done that bit. So as you work around, eventually you're going to get to your thumb colour. So you can work into the same stitch where you added your second colour, and this will help eliminate any gaps. And once you've completed your first row, you can just slip stitch to join. So it should look something like this. And then you can just continue as you did before with your half treble crochet until you've got the part that's going to cover your fingers as long as you need it to be. Once you've got the fingers part as long as you want it to be, you can slip stitch to join. And you can snip your wool and then pull your tail end through the loop to fasten on. So for the last part, I'm going to add the band. I'm going to insert my hook through one side, and then get the contrasting colour. Now I'm going to tie a knot here, but you don't have to do that if you don't want to. It's just, I like to make sure it's definitely secure. Now I'm going to weave the tail ends in here as well, just because I don't like weaving them in at the end. So once you've weaved your tail end in, if you started with a chainless foundation like I did, you can have a little gap at the other side that you just want to close up before you start. So you want to insert through that gap, and then pull a loop through, and then at your other side, just going to insert your hook, and then slip stitch together to close that gap. If you started with a regular foundation chain, you won't need to do this. And I'm going to weave this tail end in as well, just because I don't like doing the weaving in at the end. So once that's done, you can return to your contrasting colour, insert your hook, and then pull a loop through, and then chain three. So I'm going to start here with a treble crochet. So you want to pull the yarn through, and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. And do this all the way around. Once you get back to the beginning of your row, you can just insert your hook into the first stitch and then slip stitch together. So next you want to chain two, and then you want to do front post treble crochet in your first stitch. And then for your next stitch, you're going to do a half treble crochet. And then you want to do a front post treble crochet. And then a half treble crochet. You want to alternate these stitches all the way around to create the ribbed band. So once you get back to the beginning, you want to slip stitch together to join your row. So then you're going to see that your ridging is starting to take place. So next you want to chain two, and then work straight into the ribbing that you've already created from your second row. And once again, you're going to alternate with a half treble crochet, and then a front post treble crochet for your next stitch, and just keep going all the way around. And do this for as many rows as you want to make the band as wide as you want it. So once you've got the band as wide as you want it, you can slip stitch together, and then trim your wool, and pull your tail end through to fasten off. So you should end up with something that looks like this. So now you just want to weave in your tail ends. So first you want to turn your glove inside out. and then take your darning needle, insert your wool, and then just weave your tail ends in through your work. And once you've finished, you should end up with something that looks like this. So now you can try your gloves on. And those are your completed two-tone crochet fingerless mittens.